A very good day and warm welcome to a new video in English literature. So grade ones, this is your third chapter, the elephant and the mice. But before that, let's do some warm up activities. So you ready? So we start rubbing our hands. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Now, I'll ask you 2, 3 questions before we start. I'll show you few animals and you have to tell me which is the strongest of all these animals. So the first one I have here is
zebra. Zebra.
Sir, tell me, is it a wild animal, domestic animal or pet animal? Yes, it is a wild animal. So first one,
zebra.
Then we have a bird, there's a squirrel, what is this? Yes, Baba, brown sheep. So we have a brown sheep. So brown sheep, tell me, there, one more. We have a white sheep also. So sheep are domestic animal or pet animal or wild animal? Yes, they are domestic animal. Why? Because we can keep them near our surroundings, near our house, but not inside our house. There, this is mouse. What kind of animal is this? Find out and let me know in the comment section below. So here one more animal, mouse. Then we have many more to go. I have a giraffe, wild animal. The king of the jungle, lion. Crocodile, yes. Then what else we have? Oops, one second. Here we have elephant. So you have to tell me which is the strongest, elephant or crocodile, lion giraffe, mice bird or giraffe. So your answers have to come in the comment section below. So give me your answers there. Till then, let me start with the chapter. Well, we'll start with this chapter. This story is about herd of elephants and nest of mice. So story between two different creatures. Now what happens is the story we'll see later. Before that, let's go with the mind map. The elephant and the mice. First thing, elephant. What's the character of the elephant here? The elephant, he's kind, but at the same place he's arrogant. He's kind, but in the same place, he's arrogant. What are the details given about mice? Mice, loyal, down to earth, and humble. Loyal, down to earth, and humble. So, elephant is kind but arrogant. Mice is loyal, down to earth, and also humble. And the moral of the story is humility wins. Humility is being, you not thinking yourself greater than the person any other person in front of you. That is being humble. So being humble, usually when once you're humble, you're not arrogant, you don't think yourself, I am everything, then you usually win over any hard person. So that is the actual moral of the story. Now, do you know who wrote the story or from where the story has come? You have any idea? Well, I'll tell you. This story is written by Vishnu Sharma. Now, who is Vishnu Sharma? You would have heard about Panchatantras. Yes, our own Panchatantra, fully filled with lots of moral stories. This person, Vishnu Sharma, he's written many such stories, but all his characters are here only animals. All his stories are based only on animals. And every story has a moral behind it. Well, you know one more fact, this Panchatantra was written in only Sanskrit, originally written in Sanskrit. But later on, they were changed in many other languages for us to read. So you and me, not everyone can read Sanskrit. So for us, it changed. They have published it in many other languages. Now you might be knowing the story of Blue Jackal, which you learned. Yes, UKG, last year you learnt it. The cave that talked, and monkey and the crocodile. Monkey and the crocodile, I think many of us know. There was a monkey in the, he had his house in the river bank. There was a crocodile and they became friends, and the monkey, he used to give fruits, the nice fruits to crocodile to eat. And crocodile used to take it to his wife. Well, I think you have a little idea of, yes. So there are many such stories that Vishnu Sharma has written. So here, this story, we'll next go to vocabulary section. After that, we'll see the complete story. Then we'll go to the comprehension. So let's start with the vocabulary. So let's start with our vocabulary. So the first one, located. What is located? So usually people ask you, where is your school located? Where is the school located? You have any idea? Yes, Harorali Gate. So it's position of something. Location, located. It gives the position of something. Your school is in Harorali Gate. So Harorali Gate, there your school. Can you say it's in Maltali or in JP Nagar? No, it's here. So this is the location of your school, place where it, something, the position where something is. So position of something, located. Herd. Herd is group. One elephant. When many such elephants come together, it's called herd. Herd of elephants. A group of elephants is called herd. Next, trampled. Stepped heavily on. So you know how big are the elephants' legs? They're big, huge, big legs. So you can see huge, big legs. So anything comes below, so they'll become paste. So that is trampled. They keep the leg and there's a paste. The person goes. So being trampled is stepped heavily on. You are heavily stamping something is trampling. When you're walking, by mistake you stamp a ant. So you are also trampling that. So trample. Now, accepted. What is accepted? Saying yes, said yes, accepted, said yes. When you give your assignment to the teacher, what she says, okay, I have accepted this. She's accepting it. So that is telling yes, I have taken it. So that is accepted. Now, route. What is route? A way that you follow to get from one place to another. A way that you follow to get from one place to another. Now, when you were coming to school last year, bus or parent pickup or any transport. So how you, there was one route you are going and coming from your house to school, from school to house. So the same road you are following, so that is route. That is a way that we follow to get from one place, that is school, to another place, home, or home to school. So the way that we are following is called route. Now, offer, the act of asking someone if you want something. if you want like to have something. Now when there is a guest in your house, what do? You offer them water, tea, coffee or something to eat, right? So that is called offering. You are asking them, you want or you bring, you take and go. And generally if they want, they take it, otherwise say no. So offer, the act of asking if someone would like to have something. Next, trapped. What is trapped? Kept in a place from where he or she cannot run. You have heard kids are getting kidnapped or people are getting kidnapped. Once they are kidnapped, are they left outside? No. They are kept in a place, isolated place, where they can't go anywhere. They don't know the location. They can't go anywhere. So that is being trapped, from where they cannot move. Usually in forests, even the wild animals are trapped. They are trapped for what? They are trapped so that they can be taken to zoo. So trap, a place where, from where he or she cannot run. Next, rescue. Rescue. Rescue means save. Rescue means save. Usually, I just told you for trap, if kids are kidnapped. So many places, the kids are even rescued by police or anyone, any good person. So rescuing is saving that person from any trapped position or any place from where by chance someone has fallen in a well. So you rescue, you take that person out, live out. So you're rescuing that person. That is, rescue is to save. Next, nibble. Who nibbles? Yes, rats, the mice, they nibble. You would have seen, if they nibble, they leave small pieces. So they cut, they eat. That is called nibbling. So nibble, chewed. Next, loyalty. What is loyalty? Loyalty means, yes, being faithful. Being, whatever you say, you do for that person, is being loyal to that person. Humility. Humility is the moral of our story. So let's see, what is humility? The quality of thinking you are not better than the other. The quality of thinking you are not better than the other person. So that is called humility. Now it's me, and only me. I don't see the other person in front of me. So is that a good quality? No, that's not a good quality. When I see the other person also equal to me, so there is when I become humble, I become down to earth. I don't think that person is less than me. I give equal importance to that person. That is being humble or the nature of humility. So we are going to see about humility here. So let's start the story. Long time ago in a forest, there these nest of mice stayed in a big colony near the bank of a lake. They enjoyed, they were very happy. They could swim, they could drink, they can do everything around there. So they were very happy. So this happiness didn't last for long. What happened? One day, this herd of elephants came there. Now, coming to the lake is normal thing. But what happened? When they came there to drink water, this mice, they are small little creatures. Elephants are big. So when they are walking, they trampled many mice down. So many were killed. On the way, they were coming to the lake to drink water. Now, when this happened regularly, every week. So now, the king, he's the king. He has to look after his people. So what? Now I'll go and talk to the chief of the elephants. So he's all ready. Now I'm going to talk. Let's see what happens. So he goes. Now let's hear the conversation. What happens between the king of the mice and chief of the elephant. Now here, the king of the mice, he's come in front of the chief of the elephant. So elephant is asking, the elephants are big land animals. What What do you want, O king of mice? So he's telling about he's so proud and arrogant. The elephants are big land animals. What do you want, O king of mice? So from us, what do you want? So he's so arrogant. You can see his nature being so big and, you know, he's proud of himself. That time, mice, he's still calm and quiet. He says, your elephants have killed 100 of my mice. Your elephants have killed 100 of my mice. My mice are afraid to go to the lake. My mice are now afraid to go to the lake. So your elephants have killed 100 of my mice. Every time you come to drink water, you are killing 100 of my mice. So now my mice are scared. They don't want to go. Then he folds his hand. There's a request. So he folds his hand and says, please take another different route. Please take different route to the lake. We mice will be ever so thankful. So he says, please take different route to the lake. We mice will be ever so thankful. So he's telling to them, you please take another route. Why only through our route? There's a big lake, so you can go anyway. Why from our way? So you can take the other way, please. So we'll be thankful to you. Well, he was arrogant, but he was kind also. So the chief, he accepts saying, okay, fine. From now onwards, we'll go to the lake from another route. So hearing what the chief has said, mice, the king of mice is very happy. He's very happy. So what he says? He thanks. The first thing, he'll thank. Thank you, kind sir. Thank you, kind sir. We are really thankful. So, thank you, kind sir. We are indeed very thankful. We also promise to help you in your hour of need. Thank you, kind sir. We are indeed thankful. We promise to help you in your hour of need. Now, you know, the chief is already arrogant. Now this is a small creature. The creature has said, we'll help you. How can a small little mice help a big giant like elephant? So what would be the reaction of the arrogant chief? He and his full animals started laughing. They were like, the small mice help us? Really? You can help us? So they are all laughed. But still, he said, you mice are so small. How can you help us? You mice are so small. How can you help us? We thank you for the offer though. So they are all laughing. He's like, how can these people? Anyways, he says, you people so small, how can you help us? But still, we are thankful for the offer you gave. So this part is done. So he is ready to change his route to the lake, and he saved his subjects from getting trampled. Now, after few days, the situation is not same. That forest, there are hunters, there are poachers. They have come to trap elephants, the elephant hunters. So they have this big net, complete big net. And this net, what they do? They come and they completely put this net in a place, hiding place. And once the elephant goes from there, the net is on the elephant, and they're like trying to come out from somewhere, where they're trying, and they're tired. The elephants are inside, they're trying to move, where, what to do. And then there was a mouse. What did the mouse, that mice, he saw the elephant struggling. He ran to his king, and now he said to the king that elephants are trapped. So what did the mice, these people, these elephants, they laughed on the mice, the king of the mice, in front of the king of the mice. But still, what did he do? He selected his strong mice which he had in the group, he went fast to the place where these elephants were trapped. And what they started doing? The net, they started chewing from here, they started chewing from there. And when this net became loose enough that the elephant could come outside. So they chewed it, they let the elephants out. So now is when elephants realize being big is not enough, being strong is not enough. You must be humble. Even small creatures can do many things. So once the elephant is free, immediately after that, the chief of the elephants and everyone, they bow down and they say to the mice and his group, "I'm sorry, O king of mice. I'm sorry, O king of mice. You are indeed the bravest and most helpful friend. You are indeed the most bravest and helpful friend. All the elephants in the forest, thank you." So finally, what they say? They thank him, saying, "You are bravest and helpful. You are brave. You didn't think about anything. You came to help us. You are so helpful. So we all elephants in the jungle, we are thankful to you." So here we see what happened was these elephants learned the lesson of humility. They learned the lesson of humility. So students, now we'll go to the word wonder section. So last year we had learned the young ones. Yes. So here we have cow. Who is the young one? What we call the young one of cow? Cub? Then kitten? Puppy? No. Yes, we call calf. Now for sheep, what do you call for sheep? Is it kid? Kid is for what then? Yes, kid is for goat. So for sheep it is? Yes, lamb. Very good. Next, horse. What do you tell for horse? Horses? Cub? No. Horses? Fowl. Next, cat. Cat's young one, everyone knows. Yes, kitten. So, our first one under word wonder, A. We have a bear, duck, penguin, dog. Next, we have puppy, cub, duckling and chick written here. So they are mixed up right now. Now we have to match with the correct one. Bear. Bear's young one is called kitten? No. Then yes, cub. So one with B. Match one with B. Next, duck. Duck's young one is called chick. No? Yes, it's called duckling. So two with C. Next we have penguin. Penguin. So penguin's young one is called puppy. No. What? Chick. Last one, dog. Dog we all know. So dog's young one is called puppy. Yes, dog's young one is called puppy. Now we go to the sound of the animals. Who can make the sound of frog? I know many of you can make. Let me try. How is it? Something like that? Yes. And what about our national bird? Which is our national bird? Penguin? No. Then? Yeah, the most beautiful one, that is peacock. So how does peacock, the sound you have, it screams, it literally screams. So the sound, it's like screaming, like you people all getting together and you scream, no? Similarly, that also screams. Now, owl usually night, it's hoots. It hoots. The sound is called hooting. Now, the B1, the down B1 is where the sound. We have elephant, we have lion, cat, as well as cow. So, elephant sound. What do we say elephant sound? Elephant trumpet. So, what would be the spelling? T-R-U-M-P-E-T. Trumpet. So, elephant trump. Next, lion. What does lion do? What does lion do? Yes, roars. So, what do you have? You have to write which one? Roar. R-O-A-R. Roar. Next, cat. What does cat sound? What kind of sound? Bow bow. Yes? Bow bow. No. Then, meow. So, what do we write? M-E-W. Next, cow. Cow sound. What does cow do? Crocs? No. Hoots? No. Then, moo. Moo. But it's way different. Okay, moves. The cow moves. So here, we finish this chapter. The elephant and the mice. How elephant learned the lesson of humility. So students, now we know the moral of the story is being humble. Humility is the best option every person can have. So let me tell you a story about the same moral, being humble. So there was a big kingdom, a very big, very big kingdom, and the king, there was a king, he was again little arrogant, and once a beggar came and he knocked for some prasada. Is, you know, you go to temple, you get something to sweets or something like that. That's called prasada. Usually Hindus, in Hindu custom, we tell it prasad. So he came for some prasad or food or anything that he could get because he was very hungry. So what happened was, when he knocked, king told his servant, go and check out who it is. So he went. Once when he went there, he saw there's a beggar. So he said, your honor, it's a beggar. So when the beggar came inside, king said, let him come in. So once he came inside, so they planned everything to make fun. Fun of what? Fun of a person who is hungry, who has nothing. So is it right? No, it's not right. So, but still, being a king, being in that position, he asked the servant to send this beggar inside so that he could make fun of him. So he asked him to sit. Now the beggar sat. Once he sat, so the servant was asked to bring food because the king asked him, so what do you want? So he said, anything, food, anything. So he said, so the servant asked. Servant bought thali. Thali is a plate, invisible plate. So can you see anything? No, right? Similarly, the servant bought and kept it in front of the beggar. Now the arrogant king, he was like, wow, so many things, kachori, samosa, laddus, so much is there to eat, please eat. How will you feel? You are very hungry. So this man is being hungry from days. We don't know how many days. He's very hungry. And we can't bear hunger even 4 or 5 minutes. We start, you know, hitting our mom and asking food. So this man, he's very hungry. And there's a plate which he cannot see. There's a food which he cannot see again. So this man, he was very humble. He didn't want to offend the king. So kind heart. So he acted as if he's eating. He took, he's eating. So king saw that. And then he said, okay, so how is it? The beggar was like, your samosas are tasty. It's really nice. So he's like, okay, fine. Now what else you want? So beggar said, I want a wife. So king was like, okay, fine. call the girls who are dancing in our courtyard. So they came, the girls started dancing, invisible girls, girls which cannot be seen. So there's a girls, you can see, now I'm telling, please come and dance. So you can see the girls are dancing, wow, so nicely they are dancing. So you can't see anything, even the beggar couldn't see anything because there was no one. But then king was making fun. So they were dancing, say, now pick anyone whom you like and you make them, you can take her as your wife. So the beggar was like, okay, fine. And then he said, go out, I have so many palaces. You choose any one palace and you can stay with your wife. Choose any one palace and stay with your wife. So beggar humbly, he got up and he went out. But now is the point when something stuck the king. The humility of the beggar. He thought, I did so much. Still, he didn't back answer. He didn't get angry. He didn't say anything. Why? Why he was like this? Why he was so humble? So he told his servant, go out, tell the beggar to come in. So the servant went back in search of the beggar. The beggar was brought again in the courtyard. There the king asked, I was so rude. I was so arrogant, but still, why you are like this? Why you didn't say? So he was like, I didn't want to hurt you, my lord. Because you offered me something, I didn't want to hurt you. So I acted accordingly what you wanted me to do, I did it. Then the king really felt very sad for what he had done. Then what he did was, he gave one of his palace to this beggar as a gift, as a bad feeling which he had, in to lighten his feeling and, you know, to comfort that person, he gave him the palace to see. So here we see the humbleness of the beggar. Yes, the humbleness of the beggar brought the arrogant and proud king down, as we see in the story, where the humble and loyal mice, the king of mice, bought arrogant chief of the elephants down, and they learned the lesson of humility. Similarly, here in our story, who learned the lesson of humility? Yes, the king learned the lesson of humility. In our real life, we have seen, we all know about Mother Teresa, you all know, right? She is from a very rich family, but still she came to Rhodes to beg for her little ones, who were her little ones, the orphan kids whom she took from the road, the abandoned kids whom no one wanted. All these kids she used to take care, and for them, for their food, she used to go out and beg. That humble she was, not for her, but for her kids. Her kids, the kids the real parents had abandoned, such kids. So basically, we must be all humble and down to earth. So now I wind up my story, that is the story of the elephant and the mice here. So meet you all in the next video, the next chapter. Till then, take care and bye.